For people who are not well-versed in the Hebrew tradition, the Torah, is it kind of the center word?
So I would say that texts, sacred texts, are in the center. And I wouldn't call Torah word because the Torah, while it's absolutely central, it's also the word Torah means different things. It could mean the actual scroll that we take out and read, but it also means the discussions we have around it. It means the kind of oral revelations or things like Talmud or commentaries or just so many things that radiates out for the past 2,500 years that's been in response to Torah. All that's Torah. So, you know, even though things are focused on Torah, Torah really radiates out to engaging in what it means to want to connect with God's presence, what it means to have God within us and between us, what it means for people who don't believe in a conventional theology of God at all, and what it can tell us about meaning and purpose in life. So, yeah, so I think one of the things I love most about Judaism is it's very text-centered. You have, whether it's the Torah or whether you have a commentary from 1,000 years after the Torah, people really read things analytically, not literally, and read the different layers. So when you start to read the word, there are just, that's only an opportunity to go deeper and deeper. And how do you do that? You bring your own experience to the text, right? That's how you analyze and go deeper. And then your own experience is, well, it's different at different times of your life, but it's also different. You bring different things depending on who you're with discussing it. So you could have the same passage, and we would read the same passage year after year, and the discussions are totally different. Depends what's going on in our own lives, what's going on outside, reading these kinds of things in the context of, you know, the horrors of the Russian invasion of Ukraine and what, you know, all that. You have completely different discussions. And I think that we all feel like we grow together from these discussions. I mean, kind of that's what continuing revelation is. And I mean that without a particular theology or any theology attached, but kind of revelation as kind of going deeper, going, not accepting the surface layer of anything. Anyway, so yeah, so what I love about Judaism is that kind of text study and opening texts up. When I came and we started these weekly Torah discussions, I mean, it connected right away. I didn't have to do anything other than kind of be there and offer. I don't give a sermon on Shabbat. I give it's what's called a Dvar Torah, kind of a word on Torah. So I might talk for 5-10 minutes about thinking about the text in different ways, and then ask a question that opens up, and people were very ready and open for that.
I should know this, but what is the background of Hebrew? Is it an ancient language?
Yeah, so Hebrew is the language of the Bible, and yeah, it was, the Torah is a part of the Bible, so the Torah is the first 5 books of Moses. And you have the Hebrew Bible has the first 5 books of Moses, that's the Torah, and then the whole section of prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and so forth, and then the writings, which are things like Daniel and Ecclesiastes, Esther, Psalms, Proverbs, things like that. So the Bible is written in Hebrew, and it was the language of the Israelites.